Hi, I'm Connie. I'm going to talk about a bicycle. Skeletal muscle is enclosed in connective tissue at the three levels. Each muscle fiber is covered by an endomysium, and the entire muscle is covered by an apomysium. Fascicle is a group of muscle fibers bundled together by a perimysium. Fascicle arrangements determine what type of move a muscle can make and can be arranged in four different patterns. Circular muscles are also called orbicular or sphincters. The orbicularis oris muscle is a circular muscle that goes around the mouth. When it contracts, the oral opening becomes smaller. Another example is orbicularis oculi, one of which surrounds each eye. Conversion muscle is a triangular or a fan shape. Muscle have the broad origin and the fascicle converge toward a single tendon of insertion. The large muscle of the chest, the pectoralis major, is an example of a conversion muscle because it converges on the greater tubercle of the humerus via tendon. A parallel muscle is a spindle shape or a strap-like muscle. The parallel muscle is fascicles that are arranged in the same direction as the long axis of the muscle. The majority of the skeletal muscle in the body have this type of organization. One of the examples of this type of muscle is the psoas muscle. Fusiform muscle is part of parallel muscle. But the muscles have the large mass of tissue located in the middle of the muscle, between the insertion and the origin. Example of this fusiform muscle is biceps brachii. Pinnate muscles. Pinnate muscle means feather-like muscle. There are three subtypes of pinnate muscles. The one is unipinnate muscle. The fascicles are located on the side of the tendon. The extensor digitorum longus of the lower leg is an example of the unipinnate muscle. Bipinnate muscle, fascicle insert into the tendon from opposite side. Rectus femoris is an example of this muscle. Multipinnate muscle is attached obliquely from many directions to several tendons. Deltoid muscle over the shoulder is an example of this muscle.